In this video, let's see a numerical problem which was asked in the CBSE previous year examination year 2010, and it is based on the form that we started in the previous video. So the problem is, evaluate integral log x plus 1 upon log x whole square dx. Now as you can see, had it been only log x, it would be very easy for us. But this time we have log x, and that too log x whole square in the denominator. So it is becoming a bit difficult. I should be adopting an easier method for it. Let me try with substitution. If I write the solution as let log x is equal to t, then I know that e raised to the power t would be x, because this e base would go to the other side. So if this is your equation number 1, this is your equation number 2, and you have to differentiate equation number 1. So differentiating 1, what do you get? 1 by x and something of that sort. But if you are going to differentiate 1, then there will be no use of using equation number 2. So let me now differentiate equation number 2 in order to get most of the benefit. So when I differentiate equation number 2, I get e raised to the power dt is equal to dx, and that is your equation number 3. Now let me see if my question is nothing but I. So my I now changes. I becomes what? I becomes integral log x. Now what is log x? It is t. So it is log t plus 1 upon log x whole square, means 1 upon t whole square means t raised to the power minus 2. Then the whole bracket would be closed, and outside is your dx. Now what is dx? Dx is e raised to the power t dt. So it is e raised to the power t dt. And from where is it? It is from your equation number 3, and in fact it is even from equation number 1 and 2 also, let me write, because in short we are indirectly using all the equations. Now let me separate the integral. It is log t e raised to the power dt plus integral e raised to the power t raised to the power minus 2 dt. Now you know that in such kind of a questions, what do we use? We use I let, right? Wherein logarithmic should be treated as the first wherever it is. So this should be your second, and out of exponential and other things, exponential is always the last. So this should be the first. Now after this step, we have first function and second functions defined. So first function into integration of second minus differentiation of first into integration of second whole integration. And the other, let's copy as it is, e raised to the power t raised to the power minus 2 dt. Now you see that e raised to the power t is coming both ways. So we can treat it in some manner which will be easier for us. If I write plus e raised to the power t as common, then it is minus 1 by t plus 1 by t square dt. Now you see, isn't it the same form? E raised to the power f, e raised to the power x, I'm sorry, and in the bracket f dash x plus fx. So what is the answer to it? It is nothing but e raised to the power x fx plus c. So that would be the next step, log t e raised to the power t, then it is plus e raised to the power t multiply by the function, not the derivative. So what is the function? If it is t raised to the power minus 1, the derivative is 1 by t square. So it is minus 1 by t, then plus c. Now let me just substitute the values. Log t was what? If I know that my t is x with the log, so it is log x. Then e raised to the power t is nothing but your x minus e raised to the power t is x, in the upon is again t, which is log x, plus c. Or in short, let me just write the answer, making clear certain things. So it should be log x, then minus 1 upon log x plus c. And that is the answer to this question.